The last history in History's Volume 2 originated in December 1839. The church newspaper published a series called A History of the Persecution of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints in Missouri. Edward Partridge, who Joseph Smith had assigned, wrote the first three installments of this history. Partridge focuses on the early period of the Mormons in Missouri. He includes stories familiar to Latter-day Saints today, the ransacking of the printing office in Independence, the tarring and feathering of Partridge himself and Charles Allen. One less familiar story Partridge tells is that during an attack against the Mormons at Independence, church members managed to detain one of the perpetrators of the aggressions and tried to get an arrest warrant for him, but they weren't able to, and so he was released. So he turns around and gets an arrest warrant for them. As Partridge puts it, and although they could not get a warrant for him for breaking this door, yet he had obtained one for them for catching him at it. So Sidney Gilbert, John Corll, Isaac Morley, and William E. McClellan are sitting in court in Independence when news comes from a nearby settlement that there has been a gunfight between the Mormons and their opponents. There are rumors also that the Mormons have killed some of the Missourians. Again, quoting Partridge, "In a moment, as it were, all was confusion in the house. The majority were for massacring the prisoners forthwith, but a few, more humane than the rest, were not willing to see the prisoners murdered while in open court. They advised them to go to jail and to save their lives. This they did and were hurried, but with difficulty protected by those few friends to the jail, where they felt happy to be locked in. At midnight, a couple of them snuck out of jail to meet with the other Mormon leaders, and it was under these circumstances that the Mormons decided that instead of waiting a few more months to leave, as originally agreed, they would flee Jackson County immediately." So Edward Partridge turns out to be an important source for understanding this early Missouri period, but also his account turns out to be quite a gripping read.